everyone, I am Akshay Jadhav and I welcome you back to my second video lecture on basic concepts of thermodynamics. In today's lecture, I am going to cover some of the very important contents like system, boundary surrounding and universe. In system, we are going to study what is open thermodynamic system, closed thermodynamic system and isolated system. In boundary, I am going to tell you something about fixed boundary, movable boundary, real boundary and imaginary boundary. At the same time, we are going to deal with surroundings and universe. To explain the concept of the system boundary surrounding and universe, I would like to take an example of a cricket ground. Correct? Now, in a cricket ground, there will be a pitch at the center maybe, and the ground is surrounded by people who are sitting in the stands, right? And entire thing is called as what? Your stadium, right? Now, if you observe these things, this is the area or this is the region where something is actually happening, right? And this is the space or this is the region where the people are sitting, that is called a stand, and this is the boundary which is separating this region from this stand. Entire together is called as what? Stadium. Now you consider any type of shape, right? Now if you consider this shape, it is an enclosed area. This is a region in space where something is actually happening, or you can say this is a region in space which contains matter. And this is a place where some thermodynamic process is carried out. What is the meaning of thermodynamic process? In my previous lecture, I told you about the heat engine, that is conversion of one form of energy into another form, and that is nothing but the thermodynamic process. Something like that is maybe happening here, and this is an area where our more attention is there for the study. Such type of space or such type of region is called as what? System. So remember, system is defined as a region in space which contains matter where some thermodynamic process is carried out. Now, if you see this envelope, this envelope separates the system, right, from the surrounding. This is a surrounding, correct? You can compare this to this stand. So this is a surrounding. Anything external to the system is called as what? Surrounding. Anything external to the system is called as what? Surrounding. Now, this envelope which covers the system and this envelope separates the system from the surrounding, and that is nothing but the boundary of the system. Entire together is called as what? Universe. Right? Entire together is called as what? Universe. Universe possesses or universe contains system, your boundary and surrounding. So this is the basic concept of what? System, boundary and surrounding. A very important question in your examination, they may ask for 5 marks. Define system, boundary and surrounding. Now we will switch over the concept of type of thermodynamic systems. See, there are basically 3 types of thermodynamic systems are there. First, I would like to take open thermodynamic system. Right? Now, I would like to take same example of heat engine, what I have discussed earlier, right? So in this case, this is a heat engine. There will be a piston, right? There will be an inlet valve, there will be a spark plug, and there will be an exhaust valve here, correct? So this is a piston, right? And this is a cylinder, and this is a piston, and this is a place where something is actually happening. Am I right? So I would like to draw like this. See here. This is a place, whatever the dotted line I have drawn it, it is nothing but the boundary of the system. This is a place where something is actually happening. Means this is a place where some thermodynamic process is carried out. Here the heat energy present in the fuel is converted into mechanical work. That's why this is our system. This is our what? System. This is the system which may contain some gas. In thermodynamics, whatever the gas is contained in a cylinder is considered as a system. And you can see this is the boundary of the system, correct? This is a boundary, right? Now, what will happen in petrol engine? Air plus fuel, I told, that is air plus fuel come inside the engine cylinder through this inlet valve. Now, to understand this thermodynamic systems, you need to understand main two things, that is mass and second one is what? Your energy, right? In the form of heat or work. These all three are same. Here it is mass and here it is energy. What is mass? Mass is the actual quantity of matter present in a particular object. Right? Now, whatever the air fuel is coming in, that air fuel is crossing the boundary of the system. Am I right? Because air fuel from the carburetor enters into the engine cylinder when the piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center due to the suction stroke. Now, in this case, if you observe, the air fuel mixture is coming in. Means mass is coming in. Am I right? So, air fuel mixture is crossing the boundary of the system. Means mass is crossing the boundary of the system. And whatever the heat is generated due to the combustion of fuel is going out also. Am I right? It is going out also. Means heat energy is also crossing the boundary of the system. I want to tell you that in open thermodynamic system, both mass and heat energy cross the boundary of the system. Such type of systems are called as what? Open thermodynamic systems. Remember that very, very important one question they may ask, right? Define open, closed and isolated thermodynamics system. So you should draw this diagram for open thermodynamic system. And what I would write, in open thermodynamic system, both mass and heat energy crosses the boundary of the system, right? Such type of systems are called as what? Open thermodynamic system. And you can give an example of heat engine or IC engine with walls. Now, next example is what? Next example I would like to give a compressor. We know that what a compressor means. Compressor is a device which is used to compress the air. In all the service stations, we find this compressor. What it does, it sucks the air from the atmosphere, which is at normally 1 bar pressure, and it compress it, and it will increase the pressure of the air. And that high pressurized air can be utilized in pneumatic brakes, spray painting, and in many applications. Now, that will be one of the example of what? Open thermodynamic system, because air is a mass which comes in the system, which get compressed and which goes out. Means air mass crosses the boundary of the system. At the same time, you are supplying the energy to run the compressor. That's why even work is crossing the boundary of the system. So these are the two examples of open thermodynamic system. The next is closure thermodynamic system. Right? The same example I would like to take now, but I will take in the form of one piston cylinder arrangement without walls. Now this is what the system, and this is the boundary of the system, correct? This is the boundary of the system, and it contains what? Gas here. So this is a gas, which we normally say as a system. This is the boundary, right? Now if you observe it, there are no walls. This is a packed one. Already some mass is already present. That mass is not going to change because there is nothing can come in or nothing can go out because there are no openings only. Now if I supply heat to this gas, heat is denoted by letter Q. When I supply heat to this gas, the gas will start expanding. And when it expands, it will start moving the piston down. Now if you observe this, only heat is crossing the boundary of the system, only gas is getting the heat, but there is no mass transfer. Such type of thermodynamic system is called as what? Closed thermodynamic system. A closed thermodynamic system is one in which there is no mass transfer takes place across the boundary of the system. There is only energy transfer or there is only work, right? Such type of systems are called as closed thermodynamic system, and you can give example of closed thermodynamic system as piston cylinder arrangement without walls, right? The next concept is the isolated system, right? I hope you know something about thermos flask, right? In market, if you go, you will get that thermos flask. Why we use that? Thermos flask is basically used to keep the things either cold or hot, right? If you put hot water into that, it will keep that hotness for a longer period of time. And if you put a cold water into that, it will keep that coldness in, for longer period of time, right? Now, what is isolated system? Now, if I draw a simple sketch of a thermos flask, right? So this thermos flask consists of two layers actually. If you observe it properly, you will come to know that this thermos flask consists of two layers. Once if you close the cap of the bottle, whatever the mass is there, that is not going to change. It is going to remain constant because there will not be any leakage. Unless and until there is a leakage, the mass is not going to change. Right? Now this is a mass which we can say as a system. right? This is a system. It may be anything. It may be contained gas also. So there will be a boundary like this. Whatever the dotted I am showing it, that is the boundary of the system. Now in this case, this is called as what insulation. If you observe carefully the thermos flask, it contains two layers. In between the layer, there may be a air. Now what that insulation does? That insulation do not allow the heat to go out, or it do not allow the heat to come in. It is like a sweaters. In winter season we wear the sweaters. What they actually do? They do not allow the heat from our body to go out, right? So because of this, what will happen? Neither there is a mass coming in, nor there is a heat is going out. So neither there is a mass transfer, nor there is a heat transfer, and such type of systems are called as what? Isolated system. So you can explain isolated system as a system in which there is no mass transfer and there is no heat transfer. That system is called as what? Isolated and system. And you can take an example of thermos flask. But actually speaking, practically 100% sometimes isolation is not possible, because even though this thermos flask is insulated, after some time, maybe after 1 day, 2 days, the temperature either it is going to rise or it is going to fall only, because for longer period of time we cannot keep the things either cold or hot, because there may be some leakage. That's why I say that isolated system, 100% isolation we cannot possible. Actually, if we try, then something may happen, but in practical things, some leakage will be there. But you can take an example of the universe as an isolated system, because we think that universe is one entity. Nothing is beyond universe. So you can take nothing is going out and nothing is coming in. So isolated system is the example of what? The universe is an example of what? Isolated system. So this is the way you should explain the concept of what system boundary and surrounding and the types of thermodynamic system. Again, I will tell, open thermodynamic system is one in which there is both mass transfer takes place and energy transfer takes place across the boundary of the system. Closed thermodynamic system is one in which there is only energy transfer takes place or heat transfer takes place. There is no mass transfer. And isolated system is one in which neither there is a mass transfer or energy transfer. So these are the three types of thermodynamic system. The next concept is what? Boundary. And there are four types of boundaries are there. Either the boundary is fixed, or it is movable, or it is real and imaginary. So next is boundary. See, the same example if I take of piston and cylinder arrangement. Right? Now, I will draw a boundary here now. Correct? Now, if you see this boundary, now what I told, whatever the gas is present, when it receives the heat, it will expand, right? Now, this is a boundary I have drawn. This boundary is very close to this piston, correct? And because of this expansion of the gas, this boundary also moves down. After expansion, the piston may reach here, correct? Am I right? And the boundary may reach somewhat here. Now, if you observe this boundary, whatever which is near to the piston, moves because of the pressurized gas, and that is called as what? Movable boundary. Right? Now, the boundary which is near to these walls, these are the walls of the cylinder, there is no space here for the movement, and this boundary remain fixed. So such type of boundaries are called as what? Fixed boundaries. Right? Boundaries are called as fixed boundaries. Right? These are the two fixed boundaries. You can simply say boundary. This is a concept of what? Movable boundary and fixed boundary. On the other hand, if you take an example of a pipe, right, or even if you take an example of a compressor, it is like a compressor only, exhale flow compressor. Okay? Now, if I draw a boundary here, see, these two boundaries, this and this, are near to the surface where the actual surface is present. But these two boundaries, this one and this one, are near to the hole where it is very difficult to draw a boundary. So these two, top and bottom, are called as real boundaries because they are actually near the surface. Right? Whereas, since there is a hole here, we just assume that there will be a boundary, and this is called as what? Imaginary boundary. So this is the concept of movable boundary, fixed boundary, imaginary boundary and real boundary. So we have covered very important question here for which is going to appear for 5 marks. And in my next video lecture, I'm going to cover one more important question, that is properties of thermodynamic system, where I'm going to discuss what is the meaning of intensive property and extensive property. Thank you.